Well, in around 2002, I was kind of looking for a project to shoot, and I had an idea of reducing the amount of equipment that I used for it. So I was going to do something that was very simple, involved one camera, one lens, but I wanted to have this idea of using time as well. So it just happened that I happened to be in London at the Cenotaph on a Remembrance Sunday, and that fitted the project perfectly. So I kind of, the project found me rather than me finding it. So we went out and I started to take pictures and devise how the project could work from there. I think this project is important because obviously these generation of people are going. Once I started taking these photographs in 2002 and now in 2012, there were so many less people obviously from World War II, and you know, when I started there were veterans from World War I, and you notice that the numbers begin to thin out. And it kind of gives you a sense of wanting to complete the project and hurry up. You do feel that time is against you to actually record these people and to thank them. The Royal Armouries seemed to be a fantastic fit, obviously, for the work. Obviously, starting off in Leeds, where I grew up, so there's a lovely connection with that as well. And I can't really think of anywhere better for the show to be. It's kind of found its right home, which is good. The project took 10 years to shoot, but obviously you were shooting a single day in that 10 years. So it's a very odd way of cutting up time. Once you started it, you'd start off, the first couple of years worked very well and you were getting it. You're honing it, you're becoming more and more focused. Each as the year gone, you were much tighter with your edits. It kind of became easier. And then once you got to sort of 6 or 7 years in, it became a little bit worrying. You were worried that if nothing comes out this year, we'll have ruined, the project for 10 years. And it becomes a little, it was becoming a little bit more stressful. And then 1 year we had torrential rain and I was absolutely soaked, basically got pneumonia the day after. But because we got through that, we knew we could do anything. It was fine. It's no great hardship to do it, particularly when you look at what the subjects have gone through. I'd say probably 99.9% of the people absolutely really wanted to have their pictures taken. They kind of understood the project. They really wanted to be part of it. They were very, very proud. I mean, I would encourage people to go to Remembrance Sunday, go to a service, go out and meet these people because they're wonderful. And obviously you have people that don't want to talk about their experiences, don't want to be photographed, and that's absolutely fine. But on the whole, it was the most important event that happened in these people's lives, and it needed to be commemorated. It needed to be celebrated in some way. I like working on simple projects, so it was pretty much a single camera and a single lens, and they were all shot against a black velvet background, which was held up like that behind them by whoever was assisting me on that day. Very simple. I didn't want there to be too much of a technological barrier between, because doing photography you can end up having lots of lights and lots of different exposures and reflectors. And this wanted to be simple. It just really needed to be simple and direct. There needed to be nothing added. It just wanted to be simple faces. I do have a favourite, I have favourites and they change quite rapidly, but that's kind of not to be shared. The project is really a sort of democracy of faces. I want everybody to be equal. Everybody served their country, and that's the bottom line. In some ways, when you see a war memorial and you see a list of names, you don't have any backstories with that. All you have is the names, and that was the kind of feeling I wanted to evoke with it. But with people's faces. To me, if everybody served, that puts them into the same bracket. I don't want to be it to just concentrate on the people that maybe whose circumstances during the war were different, and they ended up having to do great acts of bravery as other than people that were there doing their bit. I want it to be equal. So we have no backstories, we just have faces. It was an absolute honour to do it, and it was very, very humbling. And it was a way to thank people. I think that's the bottom line of the project. The project is a letter of thanks. But without these people, we'd be living different lives.